Hey guys, welcome to Nighthawk Gliders. I'm Brad. Today we're going to build the Sandpiper 12-inch glider. This is a catapult launch glider, an outstanding glider, and many of you have been asking for a how-to video. This is your video. I'm just going to go through the basics, and let's build one. We're going to use number 11. I designate these guys. He's number 11, and we're going to use him as a guide since he's a great flyer. All right, first choice is balsa selection. We need a 3/32 inch by 3 inch by 36 inches. And we're going to cut off a 12 inch segment. And this part right here is going to be both the wing and the fuselage. So that's what we're going to cut out of here. This balsa right here is a little bit more dense than I would typically use, but for demonstration purposes here, this will do. All right. I like to use a balsa stripper right off the sheet. It does not cut all the way through. It cuts mostly through. And once I cut on one side, I flip it over, and then I just cut the other side. This is already pre-measured to a 1/2 inch. The fuselage height is 1/2 inch. I'm going to cut off two strips. Two strips of 1/2 inch equals 1 inch. That coming off a 3-inch sheet will leave us 2 inches. So this is going to be our wing, and the cord will be pretty close to 2 inches. All right, this will be our fuse, and this is going to be our wing. And we need to find the center of our wing. I will choose to mark it. Okay. And from the leading edge, I will have this as a leading edge. I want to go back 1/2 inch. So I will cut off from the center point to that 1/2 inch mark. This kind of creates a little bit of a sweep back on my wing. I think it adds a little stability. So typically my wings I will do a sweep back. All right. And for aesthetics, and also probably aerodynamics, I like to curve off the leading tips. So I'll just trim off a little bit right there. Yep. Okay. All right, so that's the general plane form. Now for our fuse, get some wax paper here, and we need to glue these two together. And I will find really quickly the center point of the fuse and create a mark. Okay, what I generally like to do is balance the fuse on a ruler and find out which side is heavier. So in this case, it is the right side. In this case here, it is the left side. So I will switch over so that the two heavy sides are on one end. And this is going to be the nose. Since I typically add, some extra weight on the nose, let's put all the, let's keep the tail light and the nose a little heavier. Just a little quick tip there. All right, these two are just going to glue together. So I'm trying to spread this across. Alright. Down here. And put these two together. I'll set them flat and squeeze them together. Okay, so I need to remember what is the nose, so I'll put a little mark on here just so I know. Okay, so here we have some tick marks, and these are indicators as to where we want to make some cuts to shape out our fuselage. I'll call this the fuse. This is where we will be creating a notch for the catapult. And we want the body kind of fat. I'm gonna draw a line to here. The tick marks were 1 inch from the nose, another 1 inch for the notch, 5 inches to this point, and 6 inches, which is the halfway mark. And there's a line right here. So this will just be a line straight to that. Okay. I like to use, we'll actually need to put a tick mark on the other side at the 6 inches. Go ahead and do that. Okay. I like to use, again, the balsa stripper. This time I have it set at 1/4 inch, which is close to, it should be half the width. I'm just going to put a little mark. You probably can't see that, but I'm going to put a mark on this side, and I'm going to put a mark on this side. And I'm going to look to see how well that lines up, which looks pretty close. I think it needs to be a little bit wider. So I'm going to adjust it a little bit. I'm going to go with that. The idea is that I'm going to be drawing this down, holding it very tightly with my thumb, to that line, maybe a little bit past that line. I'm going to flip this over and do the same thing. And this is just going to split the wood right to the mark where I need it. And then I can take my ruler and start cutting into this line right here. And since I'm kind of going with the grain, it won't be too difficult. And there we go, we have a thinner tail and a fatter body. And having a lighter tail will actually give us the ability to put less ballast on the front. And also, it will allow the plane to have a little bit more control with its tail. Okay, so for the shark's tooth, I typically like to use a saw. This is kind of a bit of a razor saw. And I'm going to cut, let's see if I can show you this, cut right into that angle. Okay. And then I can use my ruler again to finish that off very carefully. The saw works great with a cross grain cut. And there we go, general shape. I'm going to round off the nose a little bit. And that is the raw cut of the fuse. Okay, we have our fuse. We have our main wing, so we need a tail. And what I like to use is 1/16 inch thickness. In this case, it's a 3 inch by 36 inches, so I'm going to cut off a piece of that. And the tail is 4 inches long, couple marks there. Okay, 4 inches long, and it is 1.5 inches wide. What's nice about the 3-inch sheet of balsa is that these dimensions work very well, and that when I cut this in half, I actually have enough for two tails, for two gliders. Okay. I'm going to find a center point. Since it's 4 inches, it's two inches is the center point. And this is going to be my leading edge. This is going to be my trailing edge. I'm going to bring forward 1/8 of an inch from the trailing edge. Put a tick mark. And then from that tick mark, I go another 1 inch, mark that. Okay, so I will cut from the center point to that mark right there. And this will give my general shape of my tail. Trailing edge will actually have a little bit shaved off, which I also need another tick mark at 2 inches. Right there. So from the center point on the trailing edge to the 1/8 inch mark, I will shave off just a little sliver. The same for the other side. And that is the basic raw cut of the tail.